In this video, we will explain how to disassemble and reassemble the piston rings. You have to be careful when doing this, as the piston rings play a crucial role. In video 22, we will measure the pistons and cylinders. In video 23, we will mount the pistons with piston rings in the cylinders. This drawing shows the three piston rings of our VW Type 1 engine. Left of the cylinders on this drawing is the side of the cylinder head, right is the side of the engine crankcase. The cylinder head side is also called the top of the piston. The two piston rings at the top of the piston are compression rings. The lower piston ring is the oil scraper ring. When the engine warms up, the pistons expand more than the cylinders. Therefore, the outside diameter of the piston should always be a little smaller than the inside diameter of the cylinder. To ensure that the piston, both when the engine is cold and warm, still seals tightly against the cylinder wall, piston rings are used. The purpose of the two compression rings is to make the combustion chamber airtight, such that no combustion gases escape into the engine crankcase. They are not always simple rectangular rings. Here we show the cross-section of a piston from the VW workshop manual from 1970 through 1979. The upper and lower compression rings are not the same shape, so you should not simply swap them around. Compression rings also have a top and bottom, usually indicated on the piston ring itself. Top means the side of the cylinder head. The marking top means that you must install that side of the piston rings on the side of the cylinder head. To prevent oil from leaking from the engine case, an oil scraper ring is used. This is the third spring, this one on the engine crankcase side. It can be one, two or three parts, depending on the manufacturer. As the engine oil moves back and forth from the piston, the ring drains it past holes in the piston. It is extremely important that those holes in the piston are free and clean before you assemble the piston. We will now explain how to disassemble the piston rings. This tool is prescribed in the VW workshop manual to avoid damaging the piston rings. It grabs into the opening of the compression ring, while the grippers on both sides hold the piston ring to prevent it from jumping away. Open the ring just enough to slide it over the piston. This is the only way to avoid damaging them. Always use gloves. Piston rings can be very sharp. Start with the upper compression ring. Take the time to position the gripper correctly to have an optimal grip on the compression ring. Check that the tool fits snugly all around the piston ring. Open the piston ring just enough to allow it to slide over the piston without touching the piston. If you plan to reuse the piston rings, keep them separate. Take a quick look at the shape and make a note of it to use later during assembly. We then disassemble the lower compression ring. Do not open the piston rings any further than necessary to avoid damage. Piston rings play an important role during compression buildup, so proceed with extreme care. This is an original piston with original piston rings. The third spring, this is the oil scraper ring, consists of one part and can be removed with the piston ring pliers in the same way as the compression rings. Here you can see the original VW oil scraper ring up close. It is made of one part. In some versions, the oil scraper ring is made of two parts. A thick piston ring, with a thin ring underneath, which we show here. You can also come across non-factory oil scraper rings that are made of three parts. They are two narrow springs, top and bottom, with a wide spring in the middle. To remove the two narrow springs, you don't need to use the tool. They are much less thick than the original compression rings and can be removed by hand. Use gloves, these thin springs are very sharp. Start with the lower thin ring. Then the upper one. Once the two thin rings are removed, you can disassemble the wide oil scraper ring. If it is a used piston, you will need to clear it of carbon deposits before reassembling the piston rings. You can clean the top of the piston with a metal brush. The grooves in the piston, into which the piston rings fit, can also be very dirty from carbon deposits and oil residue. There is a special tool for this. Choose the right scraper to clean the full width. Each groove will have a different width. Push the scraper tightly into the groove of the upper piston ring. Rotate the tool around to clean the groove. Do the same with the groove of the lower piston ring. The oil scraper ring is wider than the two compression rings. Therefore, choose a wider scraper to clear the third groove. This tool usually comes with a set of scraper wheels. It takes some experience to use this tool properly. Take your time, clean grooves for the piston rings is extremely important for the proper functioning of the pistons in the cylinders. Check that all grooves are clean and free of carbon and oil residue. Pay special attention to the openings in the piston, which serve to drain the engine oil through the oil scraper ring. Once the pistons are cleaned, you can install the piston rings. Measuring the pistons and cylinders, we will do in the next video of this series. This is video 22. We will now reassemble the original piston rings from our AB1300 engine. You start with the third spring. This is the oil scraper ring. It consists of one part on this type of piston. You can assemble the original oil scraper ring with the special tool. This spring has no top or bottom. Push the back of the spring into its groove, which helps to position it properly. Check that the oil scraper ring moves freely in its groove. The upper and lower compression rings may have a different shape. Consult the VW workshop manual if you have original piston rings, or the manufacturer's manual if you have new pistons or new piston rings. This is the drawing of the piston of our AB1300 engine. The upper compression ring is beveled, and the lower compression ring shows an angled edge. Also note what the top is of the piston ring. The English word top, or the German word oben, indicates what the top is. Here you see the word top marked on the top of the compression ring. Now install the second piston ring, or lower compression ring, with the special tool. Open the piston spring just enough to allow it to slide across the piston without touching the piston. Guide the ring by pushing the back side into the groove. Once the compression ring is properly positioned in its groove, you can relax the tool. Check again that both piston springs can move properly without resistance. Next, it is the turn of the first piston ring, which is also called the upper compression ring. Check again that all piston rings can move smoothly in their respective groove. This piston is now almost ready for assembly. In video 23, we will show what preparations you still need to make before you may mount the piston in the cylinder. If you are using a new piston ring set, the three rings will be packed separately. Respect the order of the piston rings. If in doubt, consult the manual supplied with the set. The shape of the compression rings is indicated in the manual. This type of piston ring set comes with an oil scraper ring in three parts. You start assembling the oil scraper ring with the middle spring, which is the thicker spring similar to a bicycle chain. Make sure that the ends connect properly. This type of spring has a green and a red end, both colors should always be visible. This is to ensure that the ends do not overlap. The ends with the green-red mark, you should position at the level of the opening of the piston pin. Now position the top thin ring, starting about 3 to 5 centimeters to the left of the green-red mark. You can do this by hand, use gloves as they are very sharp. Make sure it is positioned nicely on top of the thicker ring. Check that the upper thin ring can move freely. Now do the same for the lower thin ring, but start 3 to 6 centimeters to the right of the green-red mark. Check again that all three rings can move freely in the groove of the piston. We will discuss mounting the pistons in the cylinders in video 23. But before we do that, we are going to measure the cylinders and pistons, which we will do in the next video. More information about all the parts and tools used in this video series can be found as comments under each video on our YouTube channel. See you soon!